They make up 70% of the products on our supermarket shelves. Ultra-processed foods are the ones with mysterious ingredients that you'll never find in a kitchen. Two big recent studies show they can greatly increase the risk of heart attacks and strokes. British doctor Chris Van Tulleken experimented on himself to find out just how bad the risks are, and the results were grim. Now he's fighting for ultra-processed foods to carry black warning labels, as they do in Chile and Mexico, and a clampdown on marketing, especially to kids.
Well, joining us from London is Chris Van Tulleken, author of Ultra Processed People. Now, Chris, 70% of our food sold in our supermarkets here in New Zealand is ultra processed. How concerning is that?
It's really concerning because there are two things. First of all, it has really well-studied, robustly evidenced effects on your health. So weight gain and obesity are the two effects that have been most studied. This is food that's engineered to drive excess consumption, but it's also associated, even if you don't gain weight, with increased rates of cardiovascular disease, metabolic disease, inflammatory disease like Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis, dementia, anxiety, depression, cancers, all cancers, but specifically breast and colon cancer, and also all early death from all causes. So ultra-processed food has now overtaken tobacco is the leading cause of early death worldwide.
Well, it's cheery stuff. And it's not just food that we think of as junk, right?
Yeah, there's obviously lots of ultra-processed food is obvious junk. It's all the candy bars and crisps and burgers and fast food. But a lot of it, a good rule of thumb is that if there is a health claim on the packet, it is almost certainly an ultra-processed food. So you might see high protein, high fiber, low fat. All those products generally will have emulsifiers, stabilizers, coloring, humectants. They'll have all these products that lead to something being called ultra processed. So almost all supermarket bread, almost all breakfast cereals, almost all snack bars, especially the healthy ones that claim to be high in protein or support your immune system, it's all ultra processed. And of course, all diet sodas are ultra processed.
So, Chris, you experimented on your own body. Can you tell us how that went?
Well, all I did was I ate like a typical New Zealand teenager or a British teenager for a month. So I ate 80% of my calories from ultra-processed food. Three things happened. I gained a huge amount of weight, so much weight that I would have doubled my body weight in a year.
Wow.
We saw very significant changes in my brain center communication on MRI scanning, where the addiction centers in the middle became much more connected to the habit bits at the back. And we mainly saw my hormone response to a standard meal drastically altered. So when you eat a meal, you have hunger hormones that should decrease. And in fact, mine remained sky high.
That all sort of makes sense. But what is the alternative? If even something as simple as bread is ultra processed, what are we meant to do? Bake our own from scratch?
What can we do is a very vexed question, because there will be some people listening who can go to their local artisanal baker in Auckland or any of the big cities in New Zealand, and they'll be able to spend, you know, quite a few dollars, I would guess about $10, and buy a loaf of artisanal sourdough bread, and that will be real bread. Many people listening and watching will not be able to do that, obviously. It's not going to kill you. And it's going to be better than not eating anything. But you should be raging that you can't afford real bread. And that is the situation in the UK, where more than 98% of the bread that's sold is ultra-processed, and it's an emulsified foam. It isn't really bread.
Emulsified foam sounds really disgusting. Chris, heaps to think about there. Thanks so much for your time tonight.
Thanks so much for having me.
National Party leader Christopher Luxon's here.
Yay. Welcome. Your first time co-hosting, I think, with us.
First time co-hosting. I was just thinking about ultra-processed foods. I think I eat a lot on the campaign.
Yeah.
That seems what Chris Hipkins and I do all the time.
Well, yeah, I saw a sneaky muesli bar in your possessions earlier. You might as well be outside smoking cigarettes, according to
that's exactly what Kanoa said. Turns out the better bakeries, though, as you head south down the South Island. I think that's...
Is that your experience?
I think the baking gets better as you head south. And I know I've probably offended lots of bakers up and down the country.
Yeah.
But actually, I think that's the experience. Yeah.
Yeah.
Must be a real trap for policy? I mean, any busy New Zealander finds it hard to eat well, but do you face that problem?
Yeah, I have to be honest, probably 4 months ago I realised I was probably eating very poorly, not sleeping great, and as a result I needed to have a good hard look at myself to make sure you got the energy to do the job, and it's been fun. It's
off good for you, and good for anyone that wants to, you know, make the change away from ultra-processed food. But to be honest, I'm probably just going to keep eating it and just feel a little bit more guilty now.
Then we've done our job tonight. The book is called Ultra-Processed People by Chris Van Tulleken, and it looks like this, and it's out now.